Last week we have learned about a measurement. It was a basic concept in the physics. Today we are going to start with our academic year 1920 with the first lesson of the physics, that is motion and time. So already we have discussed in the class 6 that what is the exactly the motion. So can you tell me what is the motion? Oh, some student may say that a moving object is called as an motion. Am I right? But motion, we can say that object is said to be in the motion when with respect to the stationary, means if with respect to the stationary object, if the object is moving, then we can say that that particular object is in the motion. For example, now see here. If you are sitting in the train, okay, and if the train will start to move, and at that time you can say that the trees, the whatever you will see the outside from the train, you will see they will move backward. Am I right? They will move backside. At that time you might say that they are in the motion, but actually who is in the motion? You are in the motion. Means an object in physics, we can define the motion is that with respect to the stationary object. For example, also now see, now you are sitting at home. Yes or no? Yes, you are sitting in the home. Whether you are in the motion, you people are in the motion? Yes, I can say yes, you are in the motion. Why? What is the reason behind that? How teacher can say that I am in the motion? Madam, I am sitting at my home. How you can say that I am in the motion? See, if the particular person or the astronaut, if he is watching you from the moon, or he is watching you in from the moon, he will say that you are in the motion. Yes or no? Why you are in the motion? See, because Earth rotate itself, yes or no? Earth, because of the rotation, it causes day and night. Earth is continuously moving. Yes, so I can say you are in the motion. So the how we can define the motion then? The motion is defined with respect to the stationary object. Now see, if the person is sitting on the bench, okay, and the car is passing, then he can say that car is in the motion. Yes or no? Or vice versa, if you are sitting in the car and you are moving, and if you will see the person who is sitting on the bench, you will say that he is in the motion because he is moving backside. Yes or no? So the motion is said to be with respect to the stationary object. So this is the concept of a motion. And we have learned the concept of rest. So what is meant by the rest? The object is said to be rest with respect to the moving object. For example, now see, the tables, the chair, they are at their place. They are not moving. Yes or no? So they are said to be a stationary or at a rest. They are said to be stationary or at a rest. Are you getting this? Then in the class 6, we have discussed about the types of motion. So can you tell me, we have learned the different types of motion. So can we just recall what are the types of motion? Yes, the first is translatory motion. Translatory motion means what? When that object is moving in a straight path. Yes, when an object is moving at a straight path with the same distance and a time, then we say that motion we call as a translatory motion. That motion we call as a translatory motion. Translatory motions are further classified into two types, that is rectilinear and curvilinear. Yes or no? Rectilinear and curvilinear. Now what is meant by the rectilinear? The object is said to be in a rectilinear motion when it travels in a straight line or a straight path. So that motion we say that it is a rectilinear motion. Curvilinear means what? When it takes a curve path, moving in a straight line, but sometimes it takes a curve path. For example, when an Car is moving in a car section. See, it is moving forward, but it takes a curved path. So that is called as a curved linear motion. Then next is circular. So what is meant by the circular motion? The object which moves in a circular path. Yes, can you give me some example of the circular motion? Yes, what are the example? Merry-go-round. Yes, it is the best example. Then we can say the blades of the fan, they are moving in a circular path. So that is the example of the circular motion. Next is rotatory. Rotatory means the object which moves in a fixed axis. An object moves with a fixed axis. So that motion is called as a rotatory motion. For example, you can take the rotation of an earth, spinning of a top, they move along the axis. So they are called as a rotatory motion. The next is oscillatory motion. Oscillatory motion means what? The object which moves to and fro. The to and fro of an object is called as an oscillatory motion. See, for example, you can take the swing. Yes, in the garden, you can take the example of the swing. Then also you can take the example of the swing machine needle. It moves to and fro. Then when the birds fly, the wings of the birds move to and fro. So that is the example of a oscillatory motion. Then next is vibratory. Vibratory means what? The motion which vibrates. They are called as an vibratory motion. See, all the musical instruments comes under this motion, that is vibratory motion. Your mobile phone, yes or no? You are using the mobile phone. It is in the vibrating mode, means what? It gets vibrated. It is related to the oscillatory motion. It gets to and fro. The vibration takes place to and fro. So it comes under the vibratory motion. Next is periodic motion. Can you recall what is meant by the periodic motion? The motion which repeat after equal interval of a time. That motion is called as a periodic motion. That motion is called as a periodic motion. Now see, for example, the day and night always causes, yes or no? Because of the rotation. So this is an example of the periodic motion. Then non-periodic motion. So can you give me the example of the non-periodic motion? So non-periodic means what? The motion which does not repeat after an equal interval of a time. That motions are called as a non-periodic motion. That motions are called as a non-periodic motion. Have you understood? Then the next is compound or a multiple motion. Now what is meant by compound? When an object possesses two or more motion at a particular time, means at the same time, then we say it is a compound or a mixed motion. For example, see, when you are cycling, at that time the wheels of the cycle, see, they are moving in a circular path and also they are moving forward. Yes or no? So that comes under the compound or the multiple motion. Because see, the wheel of the cycle performs two motions together. It is moving in a circular path and also it is moving forward. It is performing the rectilinear motion. So it comes under the compound and the mixed motion, multiple motion. Are you getting this? So these are the types of motion. Are you getting? So related to this, in the class 7th book you are having this activity. See, types of motion. So you have to read the examples of this and write which type of the motion is it. First is the shoulders in the march. So how are they? They perform the linear motion. Linear means is also called as a translatory. Linear means in a straight line. Are you getting that? Then bullock cart moving on a straight road. Again here it will be linear. Hands of the athletes in the race. How are they? In a circular. Then pedal of the bicycle in a motion. Pedal, it is in the circular. Motion of the earth around the sun. It comes circular. Motion of the swing. It comes periodic. See, here, actually the answer will be here oscillatory, but as option is not given, it will come periodic. Then motion of a pendulum, periodic. It means motion of the pendulum, it will come under the periodic. Then slow and fast motion. Now what is meant by the slow and fast motion? Can you just tell me what is meant by the slow and fast motion? Slow motion means what? When a particular object moves in when a particular object moves with a less speed, then we can say that motion is a slow motion. Then what is the concept of the speed? That we will see in the next video. And also the related to the fast motion, it is this both the these concepts are related to the speed, that we will see in the next video. So today's work will be whatever the types of motion I have taught you, you have to write the at least 5 examples of each. Thank you.